this class, we are going to see about the modeling of speed governor. In the last video, we have seen the speed governing mechanism. Kindly check it out in the card. So now we'll discuss about the modeling of the speed governor. So this is a complete block diagram of a speed governor. So consider the steam is operating under steady state and is delivering power PG from the generator at nominal frequency. So here there is a linkage mechanism A, B, C, D and E. First, let us see the movement of A. Let us assume that raise command del PC to the speed changer. So the point A moves downwards by a small amount del XA, and this will cause the turbine power output to change. So del XA is proportional to del PC. So the proportionality constant is KC. And let us assume the positive direction for downward moment and the negative direction for the upward moment. Second, the movement of point B. So as the increase in speed, so here in the speed changer we have given the raise command, that means the speed is increasing. So there is an increase in frequency. The frequency del F caused the fly ball to move outwards so that this point B move downwards by proportional amount of K2 into del F. So del XB is proportional to del F. So the proportionality constant is K2. So del XB equal to K2 into del F. And third one, movement of point C. So this point C and point T are linked and it is pivoted at point B. The movement of point C is decided by the movement of point A and point B. So here this del XA contributes minus L2 by L1 into del XA. So this ratio minus L2 by L1 is given as K1, and this del XA, so from the moment of A we know that it is KC into del PC. So substituting that, and second one, the moment of B contributes K2 into del F. So that we take directly since the B point is pivoted. So I repeat once again, the moment of point C is decided by the moment of point A and point B. So the point A contributes minus K1 KC into del PC and point B contributes K2 into del F. So therefore, del XC is equal to minus K1 KC del PC plus K2 into del F. So take this as a first equation. Now movement of point D. So as it is contributed by del XC as well as del XE, so the movement of del XD is the amount by which the pilot valve opens, thereby moving the main piston and opening the steam valve by del XC. So del XD is equal to L4 divided by L3 plus L4 into del XE plus L3 divided by L3 plus L4 into del XC. So the moment of del XD is decided by these two factors. L4 by L3 plus L4 is given as K3 and L3 by L3 plus L4 is given as K4. So take this as second equation. Now moment of point E. So as the value of oil admitted into the cylinder is thus proportional to the line integral of this del XD moment. So here the high pressure oil is considered. So that's why we are considering the line integral of this del XD moment. So del XE, the main piston moment, is decided by the line integral of del XD. So the proportionality constant is K5, integration of 0 to T minus del XD into DT. So here it is upper moment, so we are entering minus. So take this as third equation. Now consider all the three equations, equation 1, equation 2 and equation 3, that is del XC, del XD and del XE. Take Laplace transform of all the three equations. So the first equation Laplace transform become del XC of S equal to minus K1 KC del PC of S plus K2 into del F of S. This is fourth equation. Similarly, for the second equation, and the third equation. So in the third equation, the integration comes, so 1 by s into del xd. So these are the 4, 5 and 6th equations. Now substitute the equation 5 in 6th equation. So equation 5 is del xd, substitute this in 6th equation and multiply this k5 by s inside the bracket, you will be getting this expression. And here del xe of s in the left hand side and one more del xe of s in the right hand side. So take this del xe of s common, take this term to that side, it become 1 plus k4 k5 by s, that will be equal to this term minus k5 k3 by s into del xe of s. So take this as 7th equation. So now we are going to substitute equation 4 in the 7th equation. So 4th equation is this one and 7th is this one. In 4th equation we are having del xc. So that del xc we are going to substitute in 7th equation. If you do so, you will be getting this expression. And now multiply this term inside the bracket and take LCM, you will be getting this expression. Now cancel the s in the left hand side and right hand side here. So the equation become like this. Now in the left hand side, take this k4 k5 s common. So it become 1 plus s divided by k4 k5. And in right hand side equation, take this k5 k3 k1 k c s common. So it become del pc minus, here you will be having k2 k5 and k3 term already. So that term k5 and k3 get cancelled and in the denominator you will be having k1 and kc. Consider the last equation in the previous slide, del xe of s equal to this whole term divided by this term. So cancelling k5 term, the equation is reduced like this. So considering the last equation in the previous slide here, so the above equation can be written as del xe equal to del pc of s minus 1 by r into del f of s into kg divided by 1 plus stg. So take this as 8th equation where this k1 kc divided by k2 is the speed regulation of the governor and kg equal to k1 k3 kc divided by k4, it is a gain of speed governor. And Tg is 1 by k4 k5, it is a time constant of speed governor. So consider the 8th equation and we can draw the model for the speed governor. So del xc is the output and the input is del pc. So del pc minus 1 by r into del f of s. So you can draw a block diagram for 1 by r and it hits the negative terminal here. And the constant is kg divided by 1 plus stg and the output is del xc. So this is the moment of E and based on the moment of E, the steam flows to the turbine. So this is the model of speed governor. So along with the model of speed governor, we are going to discuss about the model of turbine. So modeling of turbine, the single block which consists of kt divided by 1 plus stt. So the input is del xc of s and the output is del pt of s. This is a turbine output. So where this tt is time constant of turbine and kt is gain constant of turbine and del pv is a per unit change in valve position from nominal value. So the combined setup of speed governor and turbine, add this block along with the speed governor block. So kt divided by 1 plus stt. So the output become del pt of s. So now generator load model. So speed governor followed by turbine, then it is generator and load is connected to the generator. So now generator load model. So consider the mathematical model of a isolated generator which can only supply local load and is not supplying power to another area. Suppose there is a real load change of del pd. Due to the action of turbine controllers, the generator increases its output by an amount del pg. So there will be some surplus of power available there. So the net surplus power that is given by del pg minus del pd will be absorbed by the system in two different categories. So we'll discuss the two categories one by one. So in category 1, So by increasing the kinetic energy in the rotor at the rate of d by dt of WKE, it is kinetic energy, the initial value of kinetic energy is given by H into PR kilowatt second. So take this as ninth equation, where this H is defined as the inertia constant. It is a ratio of kinetic energy stored in the rotor to the MVA rating of the generator. And this kinetic energy is given as half J omega naught square, where J is the moment of inertia and omega naught is the angular velocity. So from this equation, we can able to say this moment of inertia is taken as a proportionality constant. So this kinetic energy, initial kinetic energy WKE naught, is proportional to this omega naught square, where this omega naught square is 2 pi f naught square. So we can write WKE naught is proportional to f naught square. It is proportional to the frequency square. So take this as 10th equation. And the final value of kinetic energy is proportional to the initial frequency plus change in frequency. So f naught plus del f the whole square. And take this as 11th equation. So now, by dividing equation 11 by 10, you'll be getting the ratio kinetic energy divided by the initial value of kinetic energy. So f naught plus del f divided by f naught the whole square, and bring this kinetic energy, initial value of kinetic energy, to this side, divide this f naught by f naught individually. So f naught get cancelled, you'll be getting 1 plus del f by f naught the whole square. So considering this equation, we are going to apply 1 plus this del f by f naught the whole square, a plus b whole square formula. So a square plus 2ab plus b square, neglecting the second order term. So the equation become 1 plus 2 del f by f naught. So rate of change of kinetic energy, so differentiate the above equation. So 2 into WKE naught by f naught into d by dt of del f. So take this as 12th equation. So substituting equation 9 in 12. So 9th equation is this one, H into PR. So instead of WKE naught, we are going to substitute H into PR. After substituting, you will be getting d by dt of WKE equal to 2HPR divided by f naught d by dt del f. So take this as 13th equation. So now category 2. So the rate of change of load with respect to frequency is given by dou PD by dou f, that is equal to B, where B is the damping coefficient in megawatt by hertz. Take this as 14th equation, and the value of damping coefficient is positive value for motoring load. So del PG minus del PD equal to B into del F. So this is a 15th equation. So this is your category 2. So now we are going to combine these two categories. So by considering the two categories, the power balance equation will be, so refer these two equations, equation 13 in category 1 and equation 15 in category 2. So combining these two, so the power balance equation del PG minus del PD equal to 2HPR by F naught d by dt of del F plus B into del F. So take this as 16th equation. Divide equation 16 by the machine rating PR, that is base value. So the equation 16 is of a actual value. So now we are going to divide it with the base value. So actual value divided by base value, that gives you per unit value. So in power, del PG per unit minus del PD per unit, and here 2H by F naught is constant, d by dt of del F, and here this PR will get cancelled with that base value, plus B per unit into del F. Taking Laplace transform on both sides, you'll be getting del PG of S. Instead of this differentiation d by dt, you can put s here and plus b del of f of s. So simplifying, taking del f of s common, you will be getting 2hs by f naught plus b. So considering the previous slide, last equation here, now finding del f of s. So del pg of s minus del pd of s divided by this whole term. Under that, I am taking b as common out. So it become 1 plus 2hs divided by b into f naught. So now del f of s equal to del pg of s minus del pd of s, and this 1 by b I am taking it as a kp, and 1 plus s into tp, where tp is 2h divided by b into f naught. which is power system time constant. So using this equation, we can draw the generator load model. So the constant term is Kp divided by 1 plus Stp. And here the input is del Pg, which is from the generator, and this is a demand, generation minus demand into this term, that gives you the del F of S as an output. So this is a generator load model. So far we have discussed about the speed governor model, then turbine model, and now it is generator load model. Now we are going to combine all the model and we are going to draw the complete block diagram. So that complete block diagram, we call it as a load frequency control of single area system. So the combination of governor model, turbine model and generator model is a complete block diagram model of LFC of the isolated power system. So the complete model will be like this. So in this, the input is del PC, speed changer input. And here it is Kg by 1 plus STG governor model, then followed by turbine model. And here it is a generator load model. This is a complete block diagram of load frequency control of a single area system.